Hey everyone, welcome to Apigee Edge 4-Minute Videos for Developers, Season 26, Episode 8. In this episode, we're going to see how to install Apigee Edge Private Cloud on a single node machine. Myself, Anil Sagar, I work at Google on Apigee platform. Prerequisites for this video, you need to understand the installation requirements for this single node installation. For that, you can refer earlier 4-Minute Videos. Again, most importantly, remember, this type of installation is only for demo purpose, not for the development or testing or staging or for production, because generally you'll install Apigee in multiple machines to avoid single point of failure as well as for high availability and scaling. Let's get started. I'm going to spin up a VM on Google Cloud. Again, you can use your own private cloud to install Apigee Edge as long as it meets the necessary requirements that we discussed earlier. As you can see, I'm spinning up a VM, 8-core CPU, 16GB memory, 100GB hard disk, as well as CentOS 7. So let me create a VM and SSH into the machine. I'm logged in into the machine using SSH. Let's switch over to the root using sudo su command. Then let's set the SE Linux to permissive mode using sudo set enforce command. And then let's install wget using mninstall wget. If it is already installed, then you can skip this command. Once wget is installed, let's enable the Apple repo. You can refer for all these commands in Apigee docs that is mentioned in the description. If you are installing Apigee on CentOS or Red Hat Linux 7.4, then you have to make sure a specific version of libdb4 is not already pre-installed. You can quickly check that using this command. If it is already installed, please uninstall that, and Apigee is going to install a specific version of libdb4. Let's install mutils and m plugin properties. Once mutils and m plugin properties is installed, let's download Apigee Bootstrap installation file. To do that, issue the curl command with the URL pointing to software.apigee.com. Once Bootstrap file is downloaded, we're going to install the Apigee utility. For that, you need the credentials from Apigee that we have discussed in the installation requirements. So please update the Apigee user and Apigee password that you have received from Apigee to install the Apigee Edge utility. If it prompts for installing Java, please press 1 and continue. Once Apigee utility is installed, let's install the Apigee setup utility. Let's create a config file and license key that you got from Apigee to issue one final command to install Apigee Edge API management platform. Let's create those config file in /tmp directory. I just changed the config file that I got from Apigee docs, ip1 is equal to $hostname i, and you can disable the enable system check to know if the RAM is just below the 16GB, so that we can skip that, and make sure you mentioned the password according to the criteria, and then let's save this config file. So we're going to create one more text file, which is license.txt that you got from Apigee. Make sure the name and the path in the config file is exactly matching. Once you update the license file with the one that you got from Apigee, let's install the Apigee Edge platform. The last step in the installation is issuing this command pointing to the config file. And as you can see, the component we have mentioned as all-in-one, that means all different components is installed in a single machine. It's going to take a few seconds to a couple of minutes to complete the installation. Once the installation is completed, you can able to access the Apigee Edge UI. And once you see the UI, that means we have successfully installed Apigee Edge platform. The last component that is installed is Edge UI. If you see the message finished Edge UI setup and finished setup, that means Apigee is successfully installed. Let's access the Apigee Edge UI to confirm the Apigee Edge is installed. Let's access the UI. Make sure the ports 9000, 9001, 9002 and 8080 is whitelisted. Let's access. So this is my public IP of the machine. And :9000 login, then you should see Apigee Edge UI. That means Apigee Edge is successfully installed. To log in and create an API proxy, you need to first set up the org that we're going to see in the next video. Stay tuned. Thank you for watching this video. If you are evaluating Apigee, you can reach out to us using this link. If you have any questions, please feel free to post your questions in community.apigee.com. Please spread the love for APIs by sharing this video with your friends and colleagues, and subscribe to YouTube channel to get notified if any future videos.